सदाशिवसमारम्भाम् शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. Today's subject is Awaken the Sacred Feminine. Understand the whole subject. Awaken the sacred feminine. All three are unique words. Only feminine energy can be given the word sacred. Have you ever heard sacred masculine? Only feminine energy can be given the word, given the title sacred, because when it is awakened, it does so much in your system, and it has nothing to do with your gender. That's an important thing. The gender, male or being female, nothing to do with it. It is something to do with your inner quality. And next word, awaken. Only the feminine energy, sacred feminine, need to be awakened. You already have too much masculine. The whole world is suffering with too much masculine energy. If at all politics can be handed over to women, so much good would have happened to the human society, human civilization. Unfortunately, see, if it was handed over to women, it would have been completely family-based civilization. So naturally, everybody would have had their basic needs. All the basic needs would have been supplied to the whole world. Only the feminine energy need to be awakened. Only that can be called as sacred. Let me define the sacred feminine. Understand. The extraordinary creativity. Creativity will never be possessive. There are two kinds of civilization. Creativity based civilization, agriculture based. Possessive, possession based, money based. Sacred feminine means extraordinary creativity in any field. Why it is associated with the word feminine? Because by nature, without any choice, all women experience that creativity when they carry a child. During their pregnancy, their system, even if they are unconscious about the feminine energy, even if they don't know anything about feminine energy, when they carry a child, their body is made to go through, experience sacred feminine. If you are matured enough, your being also can experience sacred feminine. So the creativity, the sacred feminine part, is an extraordinary energy. In Vedic tradition, we call this as Matru Rupena Samstita. That's a beautiful శ్లోకం ఇంచండి. యాదేవి సర్వభూతేషు మాతృరూపేణ సంస్థిత నమస్తస్యై 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 నమో నమః. ఓ దేవి హు ఇస్ రిసైడింగ్ ఇన్ ఆల్ beings, bhuteshu, even the beings word is not a complete translation, whatever exists, sarva bhuteshu, matru rupena samsthita, in the form of ultimate creativity, mother, matru rupena samsthita, who is residing, namastasyai, 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 namo namaha. I bow down, I bow down, I bow down, I surrender. It's amazing, stotra. The Vedic tradition, there are two literature, 2700 slokas, which can directly give you to enlightenment, give you enlightenment, lead you to moksha. 1700 sloka is philosophy, Bhagavad Gita. The other 700 sloka is technique. Chandi, Sabda Sadi, which can directly lead you to enlightenment just by reciting. Nothing else need to be done. See, Bhagavad Gita is linguistic importance. Understand, try to practice. Chandi is phonetic importance. Just reciting. Nothing else. Just reciting. It can lead you to enlightenment. In Bhagavad Gita, it is more working like a light based. Means, if you read, understand, cognitive shift, and experience enlightenment. Here, with Chandi, it is working on sound. Just a very phonetic sound. Chant or listen, enough. Work happens inside you. They call it Saptasati. 700. On Devi, the sacred 700 verses on Devi. That is the ultimate sound vibration. I can tell you, I have read lakhs of mantras, but nothing like Chandi. Nothing like Chandi. When you recite, you can feel inside your body that creativity getting expressed. The sacred feminine getting awakened, and the Devi who resides in you in the form of creativity getting awakened, the whole body will feel the intense energy just by the sound. I'll make this our priest to recite Chandi for you guys, and I'll also recite. Maybe I'll recite little for you guys today. Today we need to work on Vyana, but one session, maybe half an hour I'll take to work on the sacred feminine energy. Because it has nothing to do with women or female body. It has something to do with all bodies. All bodies. Male can express, experience and express that sacred feminine energy in two ways. One, if you have a son or daughter, spend more time helping them grow. You will feel physically the sacred feminine in you, and mentally mother yourself help you to grow. You may think, how can I help me to grow? Means your personality, what you identify as you in mentally, physically, work on those things to grow. Try to change your physical form as you always wanted through yoga or pranayama. Try to change your mind as you wanted through life solutions, meditation. mother, you will experience sacred feminine inside you, in the mind, in your being. Sacred feminine, understand, just the uttering of the very word, you are in different plane. Your mood is different. Only one small change. Mary should have had the place of Devi or Mary Magdalene. In these two, any one, Mary Magdalene should have had the place of Radha in Christianity. The whole world would have been different. The whole world would have been different. Either the place of Devi, Parashakti, or the place of Radha was given openly. Of course, there are mystical tradition in Christianity still gives the place of Radha to Mary Magdalene and gives the place of Devi to the Mary, mother of Jesus. Still there are mystical traditions, but not the mainstream. The unique contribution to the spiritual consciousness from Vedic tradition is sacred feminine worship as the mainstream tradition. I tell you, even if everything Vedic tradition gave is lost in some tsunami or earthquake, just if this worship of women, worship of mother, the sacred feminine tradition, if that is retained, then the whole thing can be revived. Because that is the seed. That is the seed. Hinduism has at least 10,000 subsects. I can say at least. Because each master is one sect, one sampradaya, one tradition. Hinduism has at least 10,000 sampradayas. I am saying at least. If all sampradayas are lost for some reason, only this one sampradaya, the Devi worship, mother worship, is retained. I'll tell you, whole thing can be brought back. Because the whole thing is centered on this one, mother worship. Mother worship carries the blueprint, the hologram of the whole Vedic civilization. Just this one book, this 700 sloka, all the Hindu Sanskrit literatures, Vedic Sanskrit literatures, if you put together, it will be at least 10 million, at least 10 million slokas. Means crore, I am saying minimum, because Mahabharata itself is 100,000, 1 lakh. Like this, surely we have thousands of books, at least 10 million we have. If all the 10 million lost except the 700, this Chandi, the verses on the sacred feminine energy, I tell you, the whole Hindu tradition can be revived. The whole Vedic tradition will come back. That's a hologram of Vedic tradition. Hologram of Vedic tradition. I tell you, there is no enlightened being on the planet Earth without worshipping the sacred feminine, including me. I am basically a Sakta. I myself followed Devi worship from the beginning. If you see my biography and all the deities I carved, the darshan I had, all mother based. The Devi based. All enlightened masters. Really all masters. Ramakrishna says very beautifully, Shiva is Brahman, but Devi has the key to reach the Brahman. Unless she opens, nobody can reach. Unless she opens, nobody can reach. Very beautifully describes, like a house scene. As even though husband is a owner, he doesn't have the key. It is hanging in the hip of the mother. Either you need to fall at the feet of mother, or maybe the sons, small kids who are already near to mother, they can go and have the right to remove the key from the hip. Only they can touch that place and remove the key. Nobody else can touch. So either surrender to mother or people who are closer to mother, that's all. No other way to reach enlightenment. It's very poetically described, but I tell you it is a fact, it's a truth. Still, the key is with sacred feminine energy, with mother. And same way, all mother-based traditions only continue to deliver enlightenment and keep the Sangha, the stream of transmitting enlightenment tradition, alive. One of the biggest blow happened to the Vedantic tradition is women are not allowed to sit in the throne and rule the samsthanas and sannyasa sampradayas. I'm changing it. That is why I installed Anandeshwari in the same deity. Even if I put separately little gap, later on some fellow can remove it or make that as a second grade citizen. Devi as a second grade citizen. I do not want that. That is why in the same deity, in the same mold, I added Devi. Even if you take photograph, I do not want two different deities, no. All traditions which missed the sacred feminine, whether worshipping the sacred feminine or techniques to awaken the sacred feminine, lost its life within 100 years. One of the greatest thing happened to Ramakrishna Mission is Sharada Devi was included in the main worship altar within 100 years of the Ramakrishna Mission in organization creation. They found out the important component which they were missing, and they added, saved themselves. Same way, the Ramana's tradition, Ramana Maharshi's tradition, they gave place for his mother. Unless the place, representation for the sacred feminine energy, techniques to awaken the sacred feminine energy, neither enlightenment can happen nor it can be transmitted. I already made a clear rule. Of course, I have created enough techniques to awaken the sacred feminine energy and give enlightenment. Even in the Sangha, I made a clear rule. At least 33% of all the rites, whether it is a initiation, sacred spiritual ceremonies, or wealth, or running, or decision making, will be with women who experience sacred feminine energy naturally. Here I am connecting sacred feminine energy and women in this part, but that does not mean always women experience sacred feminine energy or always men does not experience. No, the possibility is more for the female body. All you need is the sacred feminine to be awakened inside you. You are enlightened. Nothing else. Because already masculine is there. That does not need to be awakened. That is too aggressive. Ugly. The sacred feminine is awakened. You are there already, where you need to be. Exactly, enlightenment means the suppressed sacred feminine in you gets awakened. That is what we say. When somebody becomes enlightened, he becomes Ardhanarishvara, beyond male and female. These unconscious idiots don't know difference between Ardhanarishvara and gay. Below both is gay, beyond both is Ardhanarishvara. Below both is eunuch, not even gay, eunuch. Beyond both is Ardhanarishvara. Of course, I am not any way interested in hurting any sentiment related to gay or eunuch. I have a deep respect for them because they are also created by human beings and it's their choice. They are also created by the divine and it's their choice. We have no right to condemn even them. All I am saying is that is different and Ardhanarishvara is different. All enlightened beings will carry that feminine grace because they awakened, experienced sacred feminine energy. So, meditate on sacred feminine energy, mother energy, healing energy. It can be a very powerful process, a very beautiful meditation technique. In two Vedic traditions, this technique is used. Whether you carry male body, female body, don't bother. Just remember yourself as a cosmic mother. That's all. Nothing else. Just remember yourself as Devi. You may think, oh, my body language, everything became feminine, what will I do? Don't worry. It will never be ugly feminine as you think. It will not be eunuch feminine. It will be Ardhanarishvara feminine. It will just only add juice to you, grace to you. Same way, when you remember your cosmic mother, if you are carrying female body, it will suddenly add the masculine courage in you. Veera of the Devi, Chandi. For men, it will add the grace of the mother. I can give you these two as a technique. One, remember constantly you are Devi, cosmic mother, and recite whenever you can the sounds of sacred Chandi, the 700 verses. These two can do a big transformation in you, awaken the sacred feminine. We will be having the Chandi Homa done at least hundreds of times in our ashram during Navaratri. Hope all of you will be here and enjoy and experience sacred feminine. Let you all experience and radiate the sacred feminine energy. Achieve and radiate enlightenment. Live and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
All that I taste, all that I smell.